Hello and welcome to Paint Shop Pro Basics episode 31. Today we're going to be covering the push and smudge tools. Why? Because they're almost exactly the same tool. Might as well cover the one single difference between them in the same video. The smudge tool, represented by this little finger, smudging things, does exactly what it says. It's like smudging paint. So if I grab this, I'm going to bring down my opacity. I start doing that. I'm smudging things. Look at that. It's smudged. How cool is that? That's it. Okay, yeah, you smudge things with the tool, but there are some very special settings that you should know about the smudge tool first. First setting is your step. Keep the step low. If you don't keep the step low, you're going to have this weird pattern thing going on. That's just very unseemly. Okay, it's not that great. My demonstration failed. It just failed hard. Okay, but keep the step low anyway. Allows for the best smudging to keep it low. The next setting is opacity. Is it a wonder that these two settings are the biggest settings with any brush? Step and opacity, your biggest settings right there. You're going to want to bring your opacity down to smudge the best. And this actually Now, the reason why the opacity is such a big setting here refers specifically to why... Not to why, but to the big difference between the smudge and the push tool, which I'll get to later. Keep your opacity low for the best smudging. If you don't keep your opacity down, watch what happens. You see that one dot there? That's my sample point. So I suppose it's time to tell you exactly how these tools work. The smudge tool and the push tool both take a sample point. This is the first point that you click on. So in this case, I click on the eye, and the eye becomes my sample point. And I use this point to do all of my smudging. So the colors around the eye will actually blend together and smudge things. I can then just drop it down. It's like I've smudged everything except for the eye. Bringing your opacity down removes that problem because the smudge tool continues to sample areas as you draw. So it's constantly picking up more and more information. With your opacity turned down, it's able to grab more information because it's grabbing from the background as well as your actual point. Pretty cool, huh? So keep your step down and keep your opacity down for the best smudging. Now the push tool, represented by this little ball being pushed along, the push tool, unlike the smudge tool, does not continue to sample. It takes one sample and uses that one only. And so every smudge that's made with this is made with the colors in your sample point only. No other colors are used at all. And that's your big difference, is the push tool does not sample, the smudge tool does sample. How cool is that? Now, you can bring down your opacity setting, and you'll get a nice smudge, but you're still only smudging with this tool. None of the other colors get smudged into it. So, there you have it. Also, keep step down. The step is so important because it just repeats and repeats and repeats. So the smaller the step, the better the smudging. Very important. And that would be the entire smudge and push tool.